toaster was once automation. These days, we call it an appliance. These days, automation is a moving target because it goes with our presumption of what is ascribed to the human. And we have a different vision of what the human does. The machines have caught up with that vision, and now we're at a very interesting time in both ground transportation and in aviation. The structure of the team itself is something that I think has evolved. Evolved for reasons that we can look back and understand, but it's evolved to a point where we're pushing to the machine to do most of the overt activity, especially the physical activity of manipulating, controlling the path of the vehicle. But with this, the human is being pushed out of much of that overt activity, and the human an important distinction with it is our current architecture still leaves the human legally responsible for the outcome. So while the machine is being given the authority to execute the flight of the aircraft or driving a ground vehicle, the human is legally responsible for where it ends up. And it's this architecture that I'd like to comment on. This is a bit of a stretch for me in the past. I know that often, particularly in the human factors or cognitive engineering domains, we've accepted the architecture and then we've quibbled over the interface, the training and the procedures. But today what I'd like to do is say, is this the right overall structure? I'd also like to increasingly call attention to the ethical question. Is it fair to expect the human to be responsible in architectures where they are increasingly being pushed away from having the ability, the information to perform the activity? Studies by Missy Cummings at Duke have reported that varying with the airplane, the pilots report hand flying the airplane somewhere between 2 and 7 minutes per flight on average. But that's just the hand flying. The rest of the time, they're a manager, watching, talking with air traffic control, working with their company, supervising, waiting to find out what 2 minutes that flight they need to intervene to keep things safe and on track. Now with this, as the technology becomes more advanced, the human's tasks are becoming rare and more difficult. It's one thing to supervise an autopilot where you're familiar with hand flying yourself and it's easy to understand what the autopilot's doing and easy to take over. But as the systems become more powerful, the amount that you are yourself normally doing the task, instead of being the manager, being the worker, goes down. You get pushed further from the core work of flying the vehicle, and with that, you're getting pushed out of the cockpit, but you still have to recognize when to step in. It is hard to monitor someone who's doing a task that you're not familiar with. And there have been some recent studies in pilot monitoring that have found that if a pilot has been hand flying, they can then be a better monitor when the autopilot is on. If you are familiar with what a good approach looks like because you have been involved in it to the point where you were forced to be assembling all the myriad cues to maintain a good and stable approach, then it is easier for you to monitor someone or something else flying that same approach and detect if something appears to be going wrong. So we're not just losing the ability for pilots to manually fly. We could be losing the ability for pilots to monitor the autopilot in true and deep ways that represent a skill-based ability to assess the operation of the vehicle. We're making the human's task harder by being rarer. They're in more extreme situations. There's something about this two-crew operation when the communication coordination is working well that I believe is magic. Magic means we don't understand it yet. And yet, if we really want to try and automate, if we really want to try and bring in more machine functioning, especially machine functioning to the point of replacing one or both of the flight crew, then this magic here is something that we do need to understand and be able to replicate.